a question about your methodology then. So, you know, how many newspaper articles have to be published? How many human rights reports have to be published? You know, what is your methodology to assess that, you know, Israel is getting undue attention?
It's a good question, because the answer is not, I mean, if it was only, look, we are not talking only about mass killings or genocide. You had a good argument. Well, because we are talking in the international media also about other conflicts and about other mass killings. Well, okay. But the demonization, and this is a big difference, is taking place only against Israel. I mean, when Britain is taking place in atrocities in Afghanistan, well, it's criticized, and it's okay. But it's only Israel that is demonized. And it's only Israel which is taking the first place in the public, in the global opinion publics, polls. Only Israel. What I want is Israel should be criticized, but also in proportions. But Israel is not criticized. Israel is demonized. So there is a big difference. Now, this is one thing. The other thing is that how comes that refugees, for example? No refugees, only the Palestinians. Can you explain it to me? This kind of obsession with the Palestinian refugees. Nobody is talking about the Jewish refugees. Nobody is talking about a lot of other things. Only the Palestinians. Nobody is talking about... Now, how many... I'll put the question on the table. How many out of the between 45 to 50 million refugees that had to experience this kind of population in church, how many received the right of return? You know the number?
The
number is zero. And there is a global propaganda war against Israel in order to force Israel the right of return, which means, by the way, if you don't know, the destruction, the extermination of Israel, and they say, by the way, they don't even hesitate to say it, yes, we want the right of return because of one reason, the extermination of Israel as a Jewish state. So don't tell me that there is not a problem. Of course there is a problem, a huge problem, which Israel has to face.
Please talk loud.
I actually appreciated that comment, and I actually think it would be great for you to collect this, because I'd be willing
to do what?
There's a New York Times archive. It would be extremely easy to search the word Israel, see how many articles come up under it versus the number of articles for Somalia. I'd be willing to bet there's far more for Israel. I've done very non-systematic searches, but there are, I mean, you could also look at the number of times it's in the front page versus maybe Somalian comes up as the back page. I think that would be very easy to collect and would probably support your argument. My question was, so you start the talk with the question, you know, does Israel increase insecurity? Or it wasn't clear to me if you answered the question. You said the world demonizes Israel for creating insecurity. Is it true that Israel creates insecurity? Well, it kills less people than other countries. So I think you have to tell us, what is your definition of insecurity first, and then answer it. So, you know, is it right to look at numbers of people dead, or should we look at the proportion of people per country? Should we look at whether it has triggered wars in other countries via refugees? Like, there are different criteria you could look at. So I was just wondering how you chose which, and what is your definition for insecurity?
I'm not sure that I completely understood the question, because the issue is not the insecurity of Israel. The issue is a process of demonization. And as I said once and again, it's not that I'm against any criticism of Israel. Let me tell you that I'm criticizing my government in many cases. So So the point is not criticism. The point is not the insecurity of Israel. I think, what I do think is that sometimes when I read, I'm not talking about the New York Times. New York Times is not the problem. And I did not check, I'm reading only the op-ed pages of the New York Times. I don't have time to read all the newspaper, of course, not every day. But I don't think that there is a problem in the New York Times, and I have sometimes a lot of debates with other right-winger colleagues that are telling me, well, the New York Times is demonizing Israel. I don't agree with them. I mean, my examples are not coming from the New York Times. My examples, as I said, are coming from sources like what not marginal people, so many, are saying about Israel, and from the outcome of the global polls about Israel. I mean, and I'm afraid because I'm talking about a process of demonization. So if you are talking in terms of insecurity, yes, I feel a kind of insecurity when my country is demonized because it does not help to solve any problem. I want a fair a settlement between Israel and the Palestinians. As long as the demonization is taking more and more place, the settlement is going to be much more far away. So it's a kind of a counterproductive process. Fortunately, I'm not the spokesman of the Israeli government. Fortunately, I published article against the decision of my government, so I have, in your case, an exemption to answer your question. So, yes, Israel should be criticized, and if you are criticizing Israel because of not letting journalists to go to Gaza during some weeks, it's quite a legitimate criticism that should be held. But I don't have any problem with what you said. It's of course not part of the demonization. There are many good reasons, by the way, why not, because also in other parts of the world, I'm talking about Western countries, they did not let journalists, etc., etc., etc. I mean, if I will make this kind of comparison, Israel will not be the bad guy in the neighborhood. But it doesn't mean that I have to agree with every decision of the Israeli government. I'm not a diplomat. I'm not a spokesman. So I don't have any problem with what you said. It's a very legitimate criticism against Israel, which can be held.
Yeah, and just on that note, I think the Israelis should do it. The Americans do it. Bad journalists.
Maybe.
So my question is related to your position as a top journalist in Israel. It's a kind of follow-up question to what Alon asked before. On one hand, you said that there is a democracy in Israel, and this is the rules of this is the name of the game in journalism. But on the other hand, I also read Haaretz, and what I read like on the last one, that Israel is like to receive the lower rating in the extent of democracy. I don't know what I'm saying, but you understand what it is. So my question is related to the mechanism, to the journalism in general. If there's any way to criticize it within, like not like as a diplomat or as a government, like as a journalist, like is there a body of researchers or people, like journalists, that can make a better order there? And where does the Israeli journalism stand as compared to the American journalism? I mean, is it a better one? Is it a worse one? Because like, the impression that I got from you is like we have democracy. But from the outside, it looks really bad. It looks like things are blocked on one hand, but on the other hand, when we read the Alex, we get like a very strong picture.
Okay. Well, there is not one stand, one opinion of journalists, not of the union, not of anything, because it's just impossible. When we are talking about Israel, I mean, whoever read even only Haaretz, he knows that, that it's just impossible. I mean, nobody is conceding a kind of block on any kind of article. And sometimes I have to tell, and I'm writing it, it's misused. So many times it's misused. And what I can do in my very little power many times is to contradict that kind of articles, which I'm doing, and many times it's translated and disseminated, but I know that it's not enough. I know that it's not enough because, yes, many times when I sit in front of this kind of audiences, people are telling me, come on, we have proofs, it was written in Haaretz. The only one way is to fight with facts, and I cannot, I don't have any other way to fight this kind of demonization, not criticism. I'm not talking about criticism. I'm talking about demonization. It's a problem. This is part of the problem of democracy. Now, comparing to other countries, I'm not sure that, I did not check it, but I read many newspapers. In proportion, I'm not sure that there is any other country in the world that is criticizing itself like Israel is like the Israeli journalists that are criticizing Israel. I'm not sure. It's what I'm saying now. It's not scientific, but reading many op-ed pages in many newspapers in the world, I think that proportions are saying that Israel is part of the problem of the demonization and not part of the solution of the problem. Yes.
So we only have a few minutes left. How many more questions are there? One, two. So we'll collect a couple of questions and just respond as you like.
Thank you for coming. This is very interesting facts. I'm just wondering. I'm so much interested in anti-Semitism issue, anti-Zionism issue, etc. Why I see the facts first time? They existed before this, right? This is so wonderful counter-attack on Arab propaganda. Why it's not there? You're talking about your book. It's wonderful to have your book. But I think that this kind of facts supposed to be in the newspaper, they're supposed to be on the internet, they're supposed to be everywhere. So it would be convincing. And certainly I would like to see your book, read your book, but
the only one thing that I can do is just to join your willingness that this kind of materials will be published much more. And I'm planning to do it. By the way, all my articles were translated to in these issues, everything, and much more than that was translated and appears in so many websites in the internet. I mean, if you just put my name, and my name is here, in the internet, you will get all the information. The only one purpose of that I must now write and upgrade my articles and make it and publish it as a book and kind of an academic is just because of what our friend here said, okay, what are your sources? And it's a very legitimate question. And yes, I want to publish it, but much more documented, much more based with all the footnotes and all the sources. And I look, but Israel has a problem. Yes, you're right. It should be much more be known, and it's not, and it's a real problem. I'm only, I don't know if you say it in English, a drop in the sea.
A drop in the bucket,
okay. In Hebrew we say a drop in the sea, but okay, a drop. I know that what I'm doing and I'm doing is a drop in the bucket. I wish I will be the bucket, but it will take time probably.
Final question, and then there's going to be whiskey after, right?
I just wanted to ask you, sir, if I'm naive, when you look at the Arab journalists who have to be hired in places like Iraq, Afghanistan, Sudan, Gaza, because it's too dangerous for a European or an American to go there now, I find hope in the fact that there are professional Arab journalists who have a professional desire to tell the news, to show the pictures, even if it's not what the Saudis want, or what Fatah wants, or Hamas wants, or the CIA wants, or Egypt wants. There's a developing group of Arab journalists that AP and Reuters have had to hire, and they are now professional journalists. Am I naive about that, or do you think that's correct?
As much as I'm following the media, or the Arabic media, which many times is serving the Western media, there are some kind of trends. Generally speaking, they serve the cause of the nation. And they serve, I mean, just like, unfortunately, many intellectuals, many unions, like the writers' union in Egypt or in Jordan, they are the most extremist. And the journalist unions are just like them. Here and there you can find very, I call it, reformist articles, which is criticizing a lot of things in the Arab countries. Not enough, generally speaking, there is a problem, even if they are educated in the West. They are still serving the national Arabic cause and solidarity. Some of them are quite honest and reformist, and you can see that, of course, they are allowed to criticize Israel, but they do not belong to what I call the self-deception way, and they are doing a fair job. But I don't have any good prospects right now that something is really changing. It's not.
Are going to find where we're going to go to have whiskey. You organize this part of the event.